My grandma is so smart because my grandmother pours so much wisdom into me. She's like, make sure you do a little sermon every day. You do a little scripture every day. And I was thinking about it, I was like, man, that's a lot of work, right? But then my grandma's so smart because my grandma is teaching me that if I do a little sermon every day, I'm going to get closer to God. I'm going to learn more about Jesus. I'm going to love Jesus more. And I'm going to practice how to share the word of God more effectively. So thank you, Grandma. And also, this is what we're doing here. I want to get a little 5 minutes devotional. If I could please have 5 minutes of your time. And I pray that we could be blessed. And if you're blessed by this, may you share this with somebody else. All right? So, Father in heaven, bless us in this 5 minutes that we have together. And may we be more encouraged to just hold on to you, Jesus. Surrender to you and to keep walking with you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So I started helping out in the cafeteria, right? And I saw that they need help in the cafeteria. And I thought, like, man, I'm going to go help out in the cafeteria. I want to go serve. But I didn't realize that by going to the cafeteria, they were ministering to me. They were being a bigger blessing to my life. Because while I was washing the dishes, God started to talk to me. And God said to me, this is what you need to learn, son. You need to learn how to serve. You need to learn how to wash dishes. You need to learn. And some people might say, man, you, how old are you? And you just now learning that? Yes, praise God. I am. I'm learning. I'm learning that God wants me to serve more. I'm learning that God wants me to love more. And it reminds me of Philippians 2. It talks about Christ. And if you go read your Bible, go to Philippians. It's a beautiful book. It says, so if there's any encouragement in Christ, any comfort from love, any participation in the Spirit, any affection and sympathy, complete my joy being of the same mind, having the same love, being full of in a full accord and in one mind. Do nothing from selfish ambition or conceit, but in humility, count others more significant than yourselves. Let each of you look not only to his own interests, but also in the interests of others. So I'm learning now, when you serve God, when you serve others, you serving God. When you love on others, that's God working through you. So if I want to be a better preacher, if I want to be a better pastor, I have to learn every day how to serve, how to love, how to be like Jesus. And when I'm serving, I'm being like Jesus. So I praise God. I thank God for the work that he's doing in me, because every day I want to learn more. I want to learn. I want to grow. I want to be more like Christ. I want to surrender my life to him. And then it's saying, who thought he have this mind also among yourselves, which is yours in Christ Jesus, who thought he was in the form of God, did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped, but emptied himself by taking the form of a servant, being born in the likeness of men and being found in human form. He humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Right? So boom, Jesus came from heaven. For you, for me, for our sins, for our mistakes, and for all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. So this video applies to everybody in the world. Jesus humbled himself and died on a cross for you and for me. He came from heaven. So who are we? I'm learning that more every day. Who are you? You need to humble yourself to God. You need to bow yourself, and your superpower is if you could come into a room and serve and love. And see how you could be an asset to others. See how you could serve others. See how you could sweep and clean and whatever you got to do. Because that's when people are going to see Christ in you. Oh, what a blessing it would be if I learned this right now. It'll change the rest of my life. It'll change your life too. And I learned too, we got to be careful. Because when we don't want to serve, where's that from? That's the first sin. Pride. One of my friends I seen in the gym, Luke, he was just speaking to me. He was like, yo, I'm learning. I got to let go of pride because it's the enemy. It is the enemy. Satan got cast out of heaven because he didn't want to worship God. He didn't want to. So that's where we got to dig deep inside of ourselves. And we got to let go of flesh, let go of pride, let go of whatever it is that's holding us back from serving and loving others. And we got to really understand where people are. Sometimes people are broken. Sometimes people are hurting. Sometimes people going through bad days. That's what they do. Why they do what they do. Sometimes people are victims of their past. We got to love them in these moments and be like Christ did and go to the cross for them. because we may be the only Jesus that they could ever see. And that's my prayer for my life, and that's my prayer for your life, because I know I'm gonna have adversity. I know I'm gonna face challenges. I know that my ministry's just beginning, and I got a whole bunch of challenges ahead. But I believe in faith through the word of God that if I humble myself and I allow Jesus to live through me, and I don't think about me, but I think about Jesus and I keep my eyes on Jesus, that's how I'm going to be able to make it through life. It's not going to be me. It's going to be Jesus inside of me. And that's my prayer for you too, that we could tap into Jesus through faith, knowing that Christ is inside of us. The Holy Spirit's going to help us. And that's how we're going to make it through. So let me pray. Father in heaven, I pray we could take this message and apply it to our lives and serve you, Lord, in spirit and truth. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you. If this video was a blessing to you, share it with one friend. Subscribe to the page. Support. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you.